Hello and welcome to the final episode of Fibers and Fabrics Season 2. Today will be a kind of a summary, if you will. I'll try and have it as clear as possible and I'll have some timestamps down below, so check the description box for that if you would like to skip forward to a certain part. Throughout this video, I'll be referring to other videos, so you can see the description box for all of those videos as well if you'd like more information on a specific episode. In this season, we had the following videos. First being, what are my clothes made from? It was the outline of the season. 2, natural textiles. 3, semi-synthetic textiles. 4, synthetic textiles. 5, what is tensile lyocell? 6, what is cupro? 7, what is acetate? 8, what is velvet? 9, what is greenwashing? 10, what is organic clothing? 11, what is microplastic waste? 12, what is a fiber? 13, what is a fabric blend? And 14, today's episode. In some of my previous episodes, I showed this chart before of the most common textile fibers that we'll find in our clothing today. I'm asking myself, where do I stand today? I've learned so much about fabrics and fibers over season 1 as well as season 2. And I knew quite a bit before, but I've really deepened my knowledge around clothing and textiles, and it was extremely interesting to me. And I really want to thank everyone who came along on the journey and watched all of these episodes with me. In addition to that, I also learned so much in my classes this year with regards to not really fibers and fabrics and materials that we used, but rather as a designer in terms of what is easiest to work with, what produces a really high quality, what do consumers like, and what are all of the benefits on a design level of all of these fibers and fabrics. So it was quite interesting to have both worlds kind of playing into one another. At the end of this year, I find myself in a place where I'm definitely going to focus on continuing buying and making a lot of clothes out of natural fabrics and going as organic as possible. It's just so extremely beneficial to the land, to the people working with the fabrics, the people producing it, all the way from the farmers to the consumers. We really have a high quality product, and from what I've seen, it is more expensive, but not that expensive, and you can definitely find a few options out there. So I'm definitely going to continue on the journey of getting as many natural fabrics as I possibly can and include that in my closet. It is definitely also the types of textiles and that make me feel most comfortable, whether it's when I sleep in it or when I exercise in it or basically do anything in it. It makes me feel best. I don't feel hot. I don't feel sweaty. It washes really well. And I love the look and feel of natural fibers. It brings me so much joy to even like touch it or look at it. So I'm definitely continuing on my natural fiber journey. The second category that I'm extremely excited about is the semi-synthetic category, or then rather the regenerated fibers. There is a lot of research and development happening in this category, where there are so many beautiful things being created and being made out of a closed loop type of fabric. I have a friend working on an extremely cool sportswear brand as well, where she's basically only going to work with semi-synthetic fabrics, and it is going to be stunning. I'm looking forward to it, and I'll definitely share it on my Instagram once it's live and available for you to consume and buy. In addition to that, I think we're going to see a lot of movement within this category. A lot of producers of textiles will be investing more heavily into the semi-synthetic category, because there's definitely a trend towards going more sustainable worldwide, but this is definitely a better way of doing so. And we still get like a lot of the natural benefits that natural fibers give us, but we can still alter the fiber length and make the textile much easier to work with. We're more in control of how the textile is going to turn out in comparison to natural fibers. So I really think we're going to see a lot of beautiful, great stuff within the semi-synthetic category. And then lastly, the synthetic textile category. I really got a better appreciation for it. I think I started off season one with a very negative outlook on synthetic fibers. And although I feel like the environmentalists might judge me now to say I have a more positive view on it, but especially with regards to the classes that I took this year, I really saw the benefit of synthetic fibers from a design point of view, and being able to offer a bigger size variety to potential customers when including synthetic textiles into a garment. Therefore, having a more inclusive type of range where more individuals can find their perfect size and feel and look really comfortable in the clothing that's produced. With that being said, I'm definitely not promoting the wear of synthetic fibers, and I won't go out looking specifically for synthetic fibers for myself. I do feel there are great benefits to add them in small percentages to some of the clothing that we wear, especially in specific type of items, especially when wearing activewear or something that you would like to have a little bit more form-fitting, tighter around your body. You won't be able to do that without synthetic fibers. So again, if you have, for example, activewear made out of a semi-synthetic fabric predominantly, and you include a little bit of synthetic textiles into that blend, you're really going to end up with a really great looking fabric that's going to perform extremely well. So there's definitely a place in modern society for synthetic textiles, and I can't see the industry going without it completely. Although, again, in my own personal life, I am definitely not the biggest fan thereof, and I will continue to use it, if I can say, use it sparingly and not include it in every single garment that I own or wear it every single day. Remember that a great way to have a certain amount of stretch or comfort in clothing doesn't always require a synthetic textile. If you have a look at knits instead of woven fabrics, you might find the comfort that you are seeking without having to include synthetic fibers. So just remember that also when buying something a little bit more comfortable, or if you're looking at loungewear, even activewear. And then lastly, a great way to have a more sustainable wardrobe is to, of course, support smaller businesses that really invest into an ethical working environment, working with beautiful fabrics that they've sourced from smaller suppliers. Sometimes the bigger companies and the bigger producers of clothing aren't able to offer such beautifully made things, unique things, even out of, you know, stunning organic fabrics. So really have a look within your community. So really have a look at smaller businesses around you that might be offering some of the things you are looking for at bigger suppliers and that you won't always necessarily find. I really hope you enjoyed this season as much as I did. I really loved making this, so thank you so much for coming along for the journey. And if you've missed any of the episodes that I've referred to today, I'll have all of the videos linked down below in the description box, so it's quite easy for you to find. If you would like to see more videos from myself, please hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell. That way you will be notified every single time I upload. Have a beautiful day, everyone. Bye.